that there were some poll numbers that were not good. I mean, from the 70s down into the 30s in a couple of different polls.
Yeah.
We've talked about polls before. You've said you don't put a lot of stock in polls.
They're a snapshot at a point in time. And when we sat here and I was in the 70s, what did I say to you?
That they were going to go down.
Right.
Yeah.
So,
I mean, polls go up and polls go down.
That's the way it goes.
But they're completely upside down at this point. I mean, if you looked at those numbers, and even if it is a snapshot in time, there has been a steady decline in some of those numbers.
There's been a relentlessly negative coverage from the media. So if you're going to have relentlessly negative coverage from the media, it's going to affect your poll numbers.
But how are you affected by those polls?
I don't really care.
Of course not. But
I can't care. Don't care, and I can't care. Because if then I would have been acting differently when I was in the 70s. Did I act any differently when I was in the 70s?
You were maybe a little more emboldened.
I just put forward the boldest Social Security plan that any potential candidate for president has ever put forward. I put forward another bold plan for pension and benefit reform, and I've been fighting on that front as well. I look less bold to you?
Sometimes.
And then when I start, then if I get even a little bolder, then, oh no, then I'm being too bold. I mean, listen, you guys have a ball psychoanalyzing me all the time, okay? I am who I am. The thing that drives others in the media, and maybe you for all I know, crazy is I don't change. That's what drives you crazy.
No, you want me to react.
You
have been the same way sitting in this chair for as long as you've done this show.
And that's my point. Like if you allow yourself as a public official to dictate your conduct, your positions, your mood by your polls, you're a dead man. Because polls will change, sometimes for reasons that are readily apparent, and sometimes for reasons that aren't.
But you do employ one of the best pollsters in the business.
Yeah, his number,
to take numbers for you.
Sure, of course I do. And his numbers are different than the ones that I've seen in public polls.
I'm sure that they are. But you do. So to say that you don't put any value in polls, you don't put any value in those polls, yet you do in your own pollster.
Listen, in my own pollster, all I get from my own pollster is, again, the same thing, a snapshot in time. And anybody who's in public life should want to do that and see those things. What I'm saying is it doesn't change my approach.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you get informed by that, and then you move on. Because if I wanted my poll numbers to go up, well, then I would just do all the things that the polls say you should do. You know, I'd raise a millionaire's tax, and supposedly that would make everybody happy, you know, or some majority of people happy. You know, if I think it's the wrong thing to do, I'm not doing it, no matter what the polls say. And remember something, too. I'm never running for office in New Jersey again. And so the idea that most people are concerned about polls because they're concerned about the next election,
mm-hmm.
I'm not concerned about the next election.